So. Now we will discuss. Okay, now we will discuss another very important concept. Okay. Just now, when I talk with students, some students feel bad for me. I have already mentioned many important concepts, right? Okay. What I mentioned important means those concepts are really important. Okay? Now we will have another important concept. Previously we mentioned when we have two videos, right? We have two videos. Medium one, medium two. Okay, medium one and medium two. Then in medium one, we have incident travel, incident wave and reflective wave, right? Reflective wave. Incident and the reflected will form the traveling wave. Okay? Traveling wave is a standing wave. Standing wave, the waveform will like this. Okay? Standing wave. The standing wave is like this one. Standing wave, okay? So now our objective, okay, bear in mind, our objective is to find out the maximum and the minimum, okay? Maximum and the minimum. For instance, for this case, maximum, for instance, is 1.5, minimum is 0.5, okay? So this is for the two dielectrical material, okay? This medium one is dielectrical material. Medium two also is a dielectrical material, okay? If later also we will explain, if medium two is a conductor, okay, is a conductor, then here the minimum will go to zero, will go to zero. Okay? The reason is reflection coefficient, later we will explain, the reflection coefficient will be minus one, means all the wave will be reflected back. Okay? Now, for instance, since medium one and medium two both are dielectrical material, only some percentage of wave will be reflected back. Turns out, this minimum will not be equal to zero. Okay? So now, what we wanted to do is to find out the maximum and the minimum, okay? The value, relationship. Also, we will find out the location of maximum and the minimum. Okay? So actually, in this chapter, there are three concepts, okay? So before our break, we have already explained the first concept is incident reflection and translation, reflection coefficient, translation coefficient, right? That two concepts are very important. That concept very important. Also, how to calculate reflective power of the relationship, reflective power, incident power, and transmitted power. Okay. Then how to determine the direction of reflected electric field, reflective magnetic field, transmitted electric field, transmitted magnetic field. Okay, right? So it's later what we will handle is the standing wave, like this one as mentioned, right? Standing wave. This is the standing wave, right? Okay, standing wave. This minimum not to zero, right? Okay, not equal to zero. The maximum, okay. So also here, take note of the coordinate system. Take note of the coordinate system. So based on our previous definition, propagation direction is positive predirection, right? So means in medium one, if we consider here in origin, then in this, in medium one, the z, in medium one, z will be negative, right? Okay? In medium two, z will be positive. The reason here, we define this is zero, right? Okay? Now, let's look at the total electric field in medium one. This incident reflector, right? Incident reflector. Okay? So, this is an incident reflector, right? Okay, reflector is reflecting coefficient times the incident, right? Okay, here is positive, this negative, right? Negative means propagation in positive z direction, this propagation in negative z direction. So, turns out the total electric field in medium one is a standing wave, we have already explained. It has local maximum and the minimum, okay? Minimum, right? Okay? But does not go to zero at any location. Just now I mentioned this will not equal to zero, but this is different from the case incident upon a conductor. A conductor, this will be equal to zero, okay? Will be equal to zero. Total magnetic field, actually is similar to this case, right? Total magnetic field. Now is negative. Here is negative, okay? So from the relationship of magnetic field, okay, anyway, it is easy to arrive at this conclusion. So in comparison, the field in medium two only transmitted wave. They are pure traveling wave. Just now I mentioned, medium two, we only have the traveling wave. In medium one, why we have the standing wave? The reason is we have both incident. Incident is traveling wave. Reflected also traveling wave. Then incident and the reflected, the combination will give us the traveling wave. Okay? The standing wave. Right? Standing wave. So this slide looks complicated, right? I need to explain a little bit. Just now we mentioned this coordinate system in z direction here is equal to zero, right? Okay. Now we introduce another coordinate system is z prime. Z prime is equal to negative z. The reason why we introduce a z prime is for here. For what is the reason why we introduce this? The reason is later when we explain the location, we don't use the negative, for instance, 1.5 meter, right? Okay. The value is positive, for instance, here the minimum is 1.5 meter, okay, right? Otherwise, we need to mention is negative 1.5 meter. The reason is very simple, okay? So just for convenience, we introduce this relationship for convenience. Okay, now, so previously we have already obtained this incident reflected, right? Okay. Now, the reflection coefficient could be a complex value, can be expressed as the magnitude and the phase, okay? So now, also we introduce this relationship. Z is equal to negative z prime, okay? Here is z is negative z prime, so now become z prime. Okay, z prime. So now here, all this procedure Okay, all these procedures are used to find out the maximum and the minimum. Okay, here just these steps are for you to understand how to arrive at the conclusion. Okay, how to arrive at the conclusion. Finally, you only memorize the conclusion. Okay, you can write down the conclusion in your forehead. Okay, the cheat sheet, right? Okay, so now this relationship is very important. So what is this relationship? You can write it as this, right? As this, okay? This is a complex value, okay? This complex value in this coordinate system, okay, in this coordinate system, you can, in this coordinate system, where is the minus 1? Minus 1 in here, this point. Which point location can represent this? This is the magnitude, right? Magnitude. This is the phase. Phase will change with z. Okay? Actually, this can be represented by the location on this circle. Okay? On this circle. With different z, this phase will change. With increasing z, the phase will rotate clockwise direction. So this actually will define the distance from here to here. This is the distance, okay? This is the distance from here to here. Then what is the maximum distance and the minimum distance? Okay, this distance is a negative 1. Now, this represents any location on this circle. So maximum must be here, right? Okay? Here, the length is this, right? Reflection coefficient. Now maximum is reflection coefficient, right? Okay? Then this is 1. So maximum is 1 plus reflection coefficient, right? Okay? Then minimum is this distance, right? Then minimum is 1 minus gamma. Right? Okay? Any question? Right? So, from here, you have no issue, right? This is incident and the reflected, right? This is incident and the reflected. Okay? So, this also we introduce this relationship, right? The reason is for convenience, just for convenience, okay? Otherwise, here is negative 1.5 meter, right? Okay? So then turns out, actually here, this relationship in this coordinate system represent a circle. This represents a circle. The radius is gamma. Right? Okay. Then the location will change with z, right? Will change with v. The maximum value is 1 plus gamma. The minimum is this, maximum is to here, right? Okay. So, now let me look at this. This is the relationship. Okay. Now, okay. Just now I mentioned maximum value, right? Okay. Minimum value. Another key point here. Just now I mentioned there are two key points. One is to find out the maximum and the minimum. Another key point, you will find is location. At the water location, you can achieve maximum value. And the water location, you can have the minimum value, right? Okay, to have the maximum value, so maximum value, this should be equal to 1. This should be equal to 1. Okay, we may go back. Means this should be equal to, this should be equal to, sorry, this should be equal to 1. Right? Just now at this location, right? At this location, okay? At this location. That is, this location is a minimum, right? Okay. So, at this location means this, the phase should be equal to 2n pi. So, n is an integral that makes this z prime greater than 0, okay? Minimum should be 2n pi plus pi. Okay, also the theta, the range is minus pi included. From minus pi to pi, this is the phase. This, what is the theta? Theta is the phase for reflection coefficient. Okay, theta is the phase for reflection coefficient, right? So, then this page more important. This page more important. So previously I used for you to understand. Okay, now we have already mentioned reflection coefficient. This is very important. Could be greater than 0, could be less than 0. Right, for this case, greater than 0, for this case, less than 0. For greater than 0, also just now mentioned, we have the initial phase. If for this case, the initial phase is 0, for this case, the phase is minus pi, right? So means for this case, the initial phase only has two cases, okay? Two situations, either 0 or either minus pi. So then for the maximum case, for this case, then this should be 2n pi. For this case is 2n plus 1 pi, okay? Then for minimum, should be equal to this, should be equal to, later I will explain to you, okay? Again, this is middle state, not the final state, okay? Then the total magnetic field, so previously here, we have already derived, later we will use a table, okay, to summarize. Here we have derived at what location you can have the maximum value, right, for two or different scenarios. Then at what location you can achieve minimum value, okay, for the two scenarios, okay. Anyway, then in the meantime, You can also derive the maximum value location and the minimum value location from this equation. Okay. From here, this is the distance between this and the positive one. Now is the positive one, okay? For positive one, for instance, we use this. Now, Just previously for electric field is negative one, right? It's negative one. Okay. Now is the relationship between this and positive one. For positive one, then we could go back. You can have better understanding. For instance, now this circle is previously this is for the electric field, right? For magnetic field, now is here, positive one. Okay? So positive one, this location will give you the minimum value, right? Okay? The same location just now, this location will give the maximum value for electric field. Means will give the minimum value for magnetic field, right? For this location, just now is the minimum value for electric field location. However, for magnetic field is a location to give us the maximum value, right? Okay, so the maximum and the minimum interchange for electric field and magnetic field, right? Okay, if you look at this chart, you can have better understanding, right? You can have better understanding, okay? Some observation just now mentioned, magnetic field maximum and the minimum are opposite to those of electric field we have already mentioned from that chart, okay? Since beta is equal to 2 pi when the prime increased by lambda h here. This sentence means this will experience a 2 period. The reason here we have 2 beta. Since 2 beta z in the exponent. Okay. Anyway, this table is very important, this table. So previously, this is the 5-star important, okay, for this concept. Okay, for this concept, this slide is very important. So previously, several slides are used to help you to understand this table, right? To understand. Then how to read this table, okay? How to read this table is very important. Okay, pay more attention how to read this table. Let's go through this table, right? Okay, how to read, how to understand this table is very important. Although we summarize here, you may not be able to read and use. Okay, now, so there are three columns. This column, and this column, right? Three columns. This column is electric field maximum, magnetic field minimum. Just now we mentioned. Electric field E maximum means the location for H minimum, right? Here we summarize at the same row, right? Okay. Then this E minimum, H maximum, okay? Means the same location, okay? Now this later we will go through other part. Now this is reflection coefficient greater than zero. Okay, greater than zero. For another scenario is reflection coefficient less than zero, right? Less than zero. Okay. Now first let's look at this column. The maximum we have already mentioned is 1 plus, right? Reflection coefficient, right? Maximum. For the magnetic field is 1 minus gamma. Okay? This condition for gamma greater than 0 is 2 m pi. Then the location, position is, this is m lambda over 2, n lambda over 2. Means for this location, The maximum is here, at just at the boundary. Okay? So help you to understand. Help you to understand. Very important. Okay? Very important. So n equal to 0. Now, maximum is at this location. Okay? At this, actually just at the boundary. At the boundary, you can achieve maximum, right? N start from 0. Okay? Then where you can have the minimum? Where you can have the minimum? Minimum, the value is 1 minus gamma, right? 1 minus gamma for electric field. Okay? So the condition is 2 n plus 1 pi. Then convert to the position, location is lambda over 4 plus n lambda over 2, means every lambda over 2. The period is lambda over 2, okay? Period is lambda over 2. Now, minimum. This is the minimum of electric field. It is lambda over 4 away from the boundary, okay? It's lambda over 4, right? Lambda over 4. So here is the maximum, this is the minimum, this is maximum. From here to here, what is the length? What is the distance between two maximum? Okay, what is the distance between, okay, what is the distance? This distance. Who can give me the answer? Sorry? Is lambda 1? I give you just now. Some student asked me whether I have the multi-choice question in the quiz or finding them. Now I give you the multi-choice. Lambda 1? One means one lambda, two lambda, lambda over two, lambda over four. Okay, this four choice. What is the distance? Okay, good. Is lambda over two, right? Lambda one over two. Here the minimum is away from the boundary, is lambda over 4. So one period is lambda over 2. Now, this distance is lambda over 2, right? Okay, here we mentioned, already mentioned. So, for this case, reflection coefficient is greater than 0. You can have this case. Then, for this reflection coefficient less than 0 should be this boundary, right? The wave, not zero. Then for this case, the boundary will be here. This boundary will, for instance, boundary is here. Then minimum is at the minimum is here at the boundary. Then the maximum is lambda over 4. Maximum will be lambda over 4 away from the boundary. Right? Okay? So now you can read this table, right? You can read and apply, okay? So this table will not be provided, okay? Although later we will show what tables will be provided, okay? If you want to use this table, you need to write this in your A4F sheet, okay? This is, anyway, it's important. Okay. Actually, the maximum and the minimum will define another parameter. This is very important. It's five-star important. Okay, standing wave ratio.
Standing wave ratio.
Is the maximum value divided by minimum value. Also, you can easily understand the relationship. This relation also very important, five-star important. Okay? Reflection coefficient and standing wave ratio. Okay, from this equation, then the minimum value of S, what is the minimum? Who can, from this equation, who can give me the answer? The minimum value of S.
Okay, I will give you a few choice. 0.5, 1, 2, okay, 1. What is the maximum value?
One.
Maximum also 1. Means this is a fixed one. Right? What is the maximum value? For what situation you can get this infinity? If the reflection coefficient is 1, right? Is a positive 1 or negative 1? Okay? Then if the reflection coefficient, the magnitude, if this is equal to 1, right? This could means this could be positive 1, also could be negative 1, right? Could be negative 1. Then the S, standing wave ratio. Actually, in short, this is so-called SWR. This is very important for my work teacher. Typically, we use this parameter in short, this SWR. Okay? Minimum value is 1 in between infinity. Okay?
1 to infinity. If some student give me the value of SWR is equal to 0.5,
this
is wrong, okay?
This reflection coefficient
for a passive system or passive system,
reflection coefficient
should be less than 1, right? The reason is for energy conservation, okay? Energy conservative principle. Reflective power cannot be greater than incident power, okay?
Now let's look at one example. This a beam, yellow light. Light also belongs to the electromagnetic wave, right? The frequency is higher, okay? Is higher. With wavelength 0.6 micrometer. Normally incident means this means normally incident, right? Perpendicular, we only consider this special case, okay? Perpendicular case means normally incident, okay? From this air to glass, okay? Means from medium 1 to medium 2, right? Normally incident. Here is, for instance, this is Z, right? This is Z, this is air is less than 0, this glass is greater than 0. Then, if the glass surface at the plane Z equal to 0, the relative permittivity of glass is 2.25 epsilon r 2, right? Epsilon r 2 is equal to 2.25. How about the epsilon r 1? epsilon r1 is equal to
what is epsilon r1?
One.
Yes, right, one. Okay? Right. This is air, right?
Okay. The locations of electric field maximum in medium one.
So then you need to determine whether reflection coefficient. If the reflection coefficient is greater than zero, then the maximum is at the boundary, right? If the reflection coefficient is less than zero, then it's lambda over 4 away from the zero, or from the boundary, right? Okay? From the previous table.
Then the fraction of incident power transmitted to the glass medium means the power transmitted to medium 2. The transmitted power actually is equal to incident power minus reflected power. You can also use that relationship, right? Okay, it's quite straightforward, right? This question is quite straightforward. So, one very important part to solve the question is to translate, understand what I asked, right? Okay? Now for this question, so you need to calculate the reflection coefficient, right? Reflection coefficient, okay? Reflection coefficient is equal to just now I mentioned, this is very important, 5 star or 6 star important. 5 star or 6 star important equation, right? Okay? Then this is intrinsic impedance, right? Intrinsic impedance is the relationship of epsilon r and mu, right? Epsilon and mu, right? Okay? For intrinsic impedance in the air is, you know, what value? It's 120 pi, right? 120 pi. Okay. Other than the air, then the intrinsic impedance, since this is non-magnetic, typically when, as I mentioned, if we don't mention mu r is equal to 1, right? Okay? So then this, since epsilon r is 2.25, actually is eta 0 divided by sigma r 2, right? So then this intrinsic impedance will be smaller than this reflection coefficient, will be less than zero, right? Less than zero, okay? Then the maximum will lambda over 4 away from the boundary, okay? Here is the wavelength. Then is, we have already obtained the solution. Is followed by micrometer, right? The location. Then the power, actually the fraction of the power, is, since you can obtain the reflection coefficient, then the fraction is actually in this number, okay? Once you can obtain, now you can obtain this, this and this, this, okay? Okay, just now we mentioned this is 120 pi, then this intrinsic impedance is mu divided by epsilon, right? Okay, it's 80 pi, so reflection coefficient is this, the transmission coefficient is this. Okay, right? Then the your first maximum, actually, just now I mentioned the first maximum is lambda over 4. Then actually, you can have multiple maximum. Is you just plus a lambda over 2, right? If you are asked to write, if you are asked to estimate the first maximum is lambda over 4. But for this question, also be careful, okay? For this question is the locations of electric field maximum in medium one. Means you have multiple location, right? Multiple location. The period is lambda over 2, right? But the first maximum is lambda over 4 away from the boundary, okay? Here, Z prime, just now I mentioned why we introduced Z prime. Here is positive value. If you use Z, then it's negative value, right? Negative value. Okay, then the fraction of the incident power actually is this. Is quite straightforward. Okay. We have already finished the second key concept. Now we move on to the third one. Third one is in this chapter is normal incidence at the perfect conductor. So previously medium 2 is a dielectric material, right? Dielectric material. Now the medium 2 is a perfect conductor, okay, right? Then what is the difference? So if it is a perfect conductor, for medium 1, actually incident reflected are the same, right? Okay? Now for medium 2, because it is a perfect conductor, electric field, magnetic field inside the electric field, inside the conductor are equal to zero. Okay, then let's look at the difference. So for perfect conductor, since sigma is equal to infinity. So from here, since this is infinity, then epsilon is infinity, so intrinsic impedance is zero. From this equation, intrinsic impedance is zero, okay? Since intrinsic impedance is zero, then reflection coefficient from this equation, then equal to minus 1. Okay, then transmission coefficient is equal to zero. So this conclusion is very important. This conclusion. Why you can have this conclusion? We start from here. Now reflection coefficient, if the medium 2 is a good conductor, okay, is a good conductor. Reflecting coefficient is minus 1. Now because of this, okay, all these are similar to what we have derived before. Anyway, here we go through. Now incident, this is incident electric field in medium 1, incident magnetic field in medium 1. Reflected now is here is reflection coefficient times incident, right, is negative x. For instance, just now, for this case, medium 1, medium 2, this incident, E I, this K, H, right, H, okay, right, H, I. Then now reflected, for this case, is this direction, right? Okay. So So for instance, the coordinate system in this is x, z, this is y, right? This coordinate system, okay? Now, er is negative x, right? Er is negative x, okay? So reflection coefficient is kr is minus z. Then, what is hr direction? Reflective magnetic field. Four finger follow reflective magnetic field, then some is reflection, is propagation direction, reflective, then rub. Anyone we need to rub, not rub, for that direction, rub towards. Right? Okay, so then edge is this direction, right? It's positive y direction. Okay? H R. Okay, this relationship very important. Six star important, okay? I need to... Okay, total electric field. Now is incident. Reflective, right? Incident and reflective. Okay, here turns out E sine. Also notice E j beta z is equal to cosine beta z plus j sine beta z, right? Then E minus j beta z is equal to cosine beta z minus j sine beta z, right? Okay? So now this is E minus J beta Z is here, minus J beta Z minus J beta Z. So turns out it's negative J sine beta Z, right? Okay. So reflective magnetic field as mentioned is positive y direction, right? Positive y direction. From this relationship, you can simply arrive at this conclusion, right? Okay, then divided by the magnitude of the electric field, divided by the intrinsic impedance, right? You can immediately write this conclusion, right? Okay? So, the total magnetic field in medium one turns out is this, since this plus this will be cosine, 2 times cosine beta z, right? Okay? 2 times cosine beta z, right? Okay? This is, as mentioned, this is a phasor format, right? Phasor format. Then we change, we can convert to the instantaneous or time domain. Time domain, you have to use this relationship, right? This relationship. Then time domain. This is the phasor format, right? Phasor format, you need to use this relationship. We have introduced in our previous, right? Okay, so this is a magnitude. Now, since we have the J, so now it's sine of the magnitude, right? Okay? So this is the real part. Since E1 is a J something, right? So it turns out here, why you have the sine of the magnitude? So previously, always the real part is cosine of the magnitude, right? So the reason is, so for E1z. So typically, if this is a real value, should be cosine of the t, right? Okay? This is magnitude, right? Okay? Why here is sine of the t? The reason is, this is imaginary part. So when we take the real part, this is cosine omega t plus j sine omega t, right? This j times this j will become real, right? So here, y is sine omega t. Okay? Now, the poles of the total electrical and the total magnetic field in medium one are standing wave. This standing wave. Okay? Standing wave. There are orthogonal perpendicular to each other outer phase, sine cosine, okay, sine cosine. That is the electric field. This is very important. Electric field, vanish means minimum.
Is minimum, what is the location?
Is actually the minimum is at the boundary. Or, okay, here, start from zero, right? Means previously we mentioned, maybe we use whatever we have, right? Here, right? This is the electric field minimum, okay? Electric field minimum. Maximum is lambda 4 away from the minimum. Okay, another minimum is lambda over 2 away. The period is lambda over 2, right? This is for electric field similar voltage. This is a magnetic field. Maximum is at the boundary. Minimum at the lambda over 4 away from your boundary. Okay? Okay, the example, after this example, we will start our tutorial, okay? Now, uniform plane wave. Is a plane wave. Frequency 100 megahertz. Travel, also be careful. Now travels in air, in x direction, okay? The electric field is polarized in y direction, means the electric field has y direction component, okay? As y direction component. However, the wave will travel in x direction. Okay, for instance, this is the boundary in medium one and medium two, right? Okay, so medium one is air, right? Is air. Now, this traveling direction, okay? Traveling direction, x, okay? Traveling direction. Now, the electric field is y direction, right? So in this case, we define this as positive y. First you need to define your coordinate system. This is x. Then what is z direction? You need to define your coordinate system. X direction, right? Look towards y, then z is out of paper, right? This is positive z, okay? Positive z. This is the if incident, right? Incident. Then incident h should be this direction, right? Okay. Now the wave impinge normally, right, is perpendicular to the boundary. Perfect. Now is normally the medium two is a perfect conductor, right? Medium two is a perfect conductor. The magnitude of incident is this value. Its initial phase is zero. Initial phase is zero. So write the phasor and the instantaneous. Means you need to write the frequency domain and time domain expression for electric field and the magnetic field. So some student can maybe just write electric instantaneous, or just write the phasor. Actually, it's very straightforward, right? For this question, you should get full mark, right? For some question, difficult question, you could get lost, right? But for this, you should try to get full mark, okay? For similar questions. Now, this incident, incident reflector, total electric field. This means total electric. Total means incident plus reflector. Okay. That determines the position nearest to the boundary, conductive plane. Means. Okay. So for this case, just now we have already mentioned. In the air, intrinsic impedance is 120 pi. Then propagation constant, actually you can use this. Is omega over c. Omega, just now we mentioned the operating frequency is 100 megahertz. 100 megahertz is 10 to 8, right? So the beta, you can obtain beta or k. This, then the phasor expression for incident, this is peak value, magnitude, right? Okay, minus j beta x. It's quite straightforward, right? Quite straightforward. You can write the phasor format, right? Okay, so most important is this relationship, right? Okay? Previously, I have already mentioned this beta propagation constant is very important, right? Very important parameter. So now the question is, we will invest more time to understand how to apply those concepts, okay, in the right place, okay, in the right place. Then the magnetic field, also quite straightforward, right? Electric field divided by intrinsic impedance, right? Divided by intrinsic impedance, then you can get your magnetic field. So the magnetic field is a direction. Just now we mentioned the direction. So the direction, the coordinate definition, the instant direction, the electric field, magnetic field, the right hand rule, right? You should be able to use the right hand rule. Then if you can use that, then you can solve this without big difficulty, right? Then time domain, instantaneous expression, also quite straightforward, because it's cosine, omega t, then minus this, minus this, right? Okay? Then the time domain, magnetic field, also quite straightforward, okay? Quite straightforward. Then the reflector also not difficult. The reflection coefficient is minus one, right? Reflection coefficient is minus one. Okay. Just now we mentioned for this case the propagation direction x, this incident y, right? X. Reflection. reflection coefficient is ER, right? Since this air, this is a good conductor, reflection coefficient is minus 1, right? Okay, then propagation must be minus x reflective, right? Okay? This is a reflection direction, reflected wave traveling direction, then the H field. E field is 4 finger, right? Then wrap towards, okay, then H should be, right? As mentioned, need to define this. This is Y, X, Y, X, Y, Z. Z is positive, is Z direction. So from this relationship, H, I is positive Z. H large also should be positive Z. Now let me look at this, should be positive Z, right? Must be positive Z, okay? So then this relation is quite straightforward, right? Quite straightforward, right? Okay, quite straightforward. Then for the reflected, notice here is positive, right? Positive, okay? This is positive. This is quite straightforward, right? Once you can understand this, okay? I guess you should not have a big difficulty to solve this problem, right? This is a very important concept, very important question, right? To combine the chapter 1 for the second part and the chapter 3 of this chapter, right? Okay? If we have one problem, one question for you to answer, most likely, right, we should have similar questions. Then the total field is incident plus reflected, right? Incident plus reflected is quite straightforward. Okay? Quite straightforward. Right? Okay? Then for magnetic field, also incident plus reflected. So then the instantaneous, just follow this procedure, right? Follow this procedure. You can get the time domain and frequency domain. Also mention the electric field, minimum is at the boundary. So the nearest minimum is lambda over 2 away from the boundary, right? Lambda over 2 is 1.5 meter. Okay? Then what? Let me check. Have we calculated the wavelength? Wavelength. Okay, anyway, you can calculate the wavelength from the operating frequency, okay? Wavelength actually is 2 pi over k, right? 3 meter. It's 3 meter, right? So then lambda is 3 meter, then half wavelength is 1.5 meter, right? This half wavelength is 1.5 meter, okay, right? 2 pi over beta is lambda, okay? So for this chapter, actually, we have learned 3 key concepts. One is transmission, reflection,
and transmission reflection, reflection coefficient, transmission coefficient, right? Then maximum value and the minimum value for standing wave. So that is for a scenario is both medium dielectric material, right? Then the third concept is the second medium is a good conductor, right? Okay, good conductor. Okay, now we have complete chapter 3. This is the last slide for chapter 3. Not difficult, right? So for wave propagation, we have explained, we have already explained plane wave transmission in lossless medium and lossy medium. Okay, then this chapter we cover the transmission reflection, reflection and the transmission in two different medium. Okay, now we'll move on to tutorial 1. Okay, so have you attempted not yet, right? Based on our schedule, okay, based on our original schedule, today we need to discuss our tutorial for plane wave. So for plane wave, we will actually, for second half, we have almost complete, more than half, right? Plane wave in lossless medium, lossy medium, and reflection transmission, okay, reflection transmission. So the next two sessions, we will cover the transmission line equation. Transmission line equation, if you can have better understanding of the plane wave transmission, reflection and the transmission, then you will have, you can understand those equations easily, okay, in transmission line chapters, okay? So today we will discuss the tutorial for plane wave in lossless and very good question in lossy medium, okay? Two questions in plane wave in lossless medium. Okay, now this is tutorial 1. So anyone has attempted the tutorial question? Anyone has attempted? No? No time, right? No time, okay? Now let's go through the question first, okay? Let's go through the question first. Not difficult, okay? Not difficult. Also, some students just now asked me whether we have the past year quiz template, right? For example, my answer is actually they are very similar to our sample in our lecture notes and tutorials or assignments, okay? Now let's read through this electric field of plane wave in free space. You should be careful some keywords, okay? Some keywords. Now, electric field in free space is given by, this is time domain, right? It's time domain.
When you see this, you have moment. Now, electric field in this y direction. Okay, find the direction of wave propagation. What is the wave propagation direction? So from this expression, what is? Sorry? Okay. Agree or disagree? Okay. Yes. Now wave propagation minus x, right? Minus x. Okay. Then maybe we define. We define. This is y, x, u. Okay. So now we propagate in this direction, right? Okay. So this definition, the collinear definition, is clear or not? This collinear definition. Is it great or not?
No.
Not great. What's wrong with this definition? So based on the right hand rule, based on the right hand rule, x this direction, right? Run towards y, then z should be in this direction, right? Okay, right? So this not great. Okay? Z should be in this direction. Right? X, Y, Z, right? Okay? Okay, this is a coordinate system definition, very important. Now, this is a K direction for this. Right, the k direction, negative x. Then this is e direction, right? E direction. Then what is h direction? This. What is h direction? Should be, yes, yes, right, okay, h equals to h is k direction, right, okay, h should be minus z direction, okay, right, okay, now we can find this, okay, find the direction of the wave, although in this question we didn't ask you to write the h, right? But anyway, from this relationship, you should be able to write this, okay? Right? Should be understand the relationship, the electric and magnetic field, right? We can do something beyond this question, okay? Beyond this question. Calculate the wave number. Wave number, here is, this is omega, right? Okay, omega, what the relationship k is omega over c, right? K is equal to omega mu epsilon, right? Okay, c is equal to 1 over right? Okay? Actually, K is omega over C. Okay? Since in free space, what is the C value?
C
In free space, C is 3 × 10^8, right? Okay. Omega is 10^8, right? Right? So then K is 1/3. So from this equation, you can calculate the K. Right? Okay? Then from K, here, the time required for the wave to travel a distance of λ/2. The time, the wavelength, this is relation, 2π/k. Then λ/2 divided by the time for this is λ/2 divided by C should be the time required for the wave travel distance of λ/2. Should be correct, right? Okay. Then basically we have almost finished this question. Now let me look at the phonetic solution. Then sketch the wave. This is quite straightforward. Just the cosine. Okay? Function. Just the cosine function. Just now we mentioned this K, right? Omega/C, this direction of propagation, negative x direction. Lambda is 6/π, then λ/2 divided by C, right? You can get this number. Then the wave only y, okay. This is how to the wave, of course you need to write this t to zero in this. Anyway you can write this equation, right? You can write this. This is given, right? For t equal to zero, then you have this. K now you have calculate this, right? This just a cosine function. Okay? π/2π, you can get this function, this function, okay? So turn out, this for t equal to 0, λ/4, λ/2, right? This wave is moving, okay? The peak will move from this to this location, then to this location. Okay? Right? Okay? This is not difficult. This is not difficult. Right? Now, this is the first question. So we just apply those concepts, what we have learned. Right? So the challenge now. Let me share with you what the challenge you could face is. You write those so many important concepts in one paper, right? Then you don't know how to apply. Although you know every equation is important, right? Okay? So then the magic. What is the magic? You can succeed. Some students cannot apply. Is the what is the magic? Is time. If there's more time, then you can have higher chance to apply those successfully. Okay, right? Now the second question. Okay. Electric field of uniform plane wave propagate dielectrical, okay, non-magnetic, this sometimes we use this quite often. Non-magnetic means mu equal to mu zero, means mu r equal to one, okay? Non-magnetic, okay? Don't ask me again during the final exam, what does this mean, okay? What does this mean? We have highlight, okay? This means mu I one. Now it's giving, okay, electric field. Now in x direction. Then, okay, determine the frequency. What is the frequency? Omega is equal to, from this expression, omega is, this is omega, right? What is k? What is the k value? K. Okay, what is the wave propagation direction? What is the wave propagation direction? Positive x? Wave propagation direction? Is it correct? Positive x? Or positive k direction. Okay. So then what is the k value? One over square root of three, right? This is omega t minus kz. Okay? Minus kz, right? Okay? Okay, this. Now since k is given, then the wavelength, two pi over k, right? Okay, so then we have calculate the wavelength. Omega is 10 to 8, okay, right? Then the second question, what is the dielectric constant of the medium? What is the dielectric constant of the medium? So for this question, okay, K should be equal to omega over mu p, right? This mu is the velocity of the phase. So now mu p is omega over k. Okay. If this is equal to 3 times 10 to 8, then the epsilon r of the medium should be equal to if this is equal to this. Then now we are asked, so last time we mentioned this could give some difference between students' mass, right? Okay? Now for this question. Okay, omega of k, now what is the value? Definitely is not equal, right? Okay? Now less than 3 times to a. Right? Okay? If equal to this, means epsilon r is equal to 1. Now less than this value, means epsilon r is greater than 1. Right? Greater than 1. Okay? The velocity is equal to c squared epsilon divided by square epsilon r, right? Okay? Now this is equal to 10 to 8, right? This is 1 over square of 3. Right? So then velocity is this value, right? So then what is the epsilon r value? What is the epsilon r value? C, what is the C? It's 3 times to A, right? Then epsilon r must be equal to, I can give you 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, 6. Which value? Because your answer. What is the epsilon value? Yes, 3. Okay, you get a few marks. Okay, if it is fine. Okay, then find an expression for the corresponding instantaneous H field. Then what relationship we should use? H field. Right? H field, what is the relationship of H field and electric field? What parameters you should use? Electric field and magnetic field, as I mentioned, one is similar to voltage, another is similar to current, right? Magnetic field is similar to current. So the relationship is current should be equal to voltage divided by impedance, right? Now we should use the intrinsic impedance. Intrinsic impedance, free space, what is the value? 100 pi, right? Okay? Now in this video, the definition of intrinsic impedance. Right? Now epsilon, we have epsilon r is greater than 1. So then this value is 100 pi divided by epsilon r 1. Okay? Right? Okay. So then this intrinsic impedance is 120 pi divided by this value. Right? Okay, so the H field is electric field divided by this value. Right? Then the direction is, what is the direction of magnetic field? So propagation in this direction, right? K direction, this K direction, X direction. In this x direction, this z direction. Of course, we need to define the coordinate system. In the coordinate system, this is y direction, right? This x, y direction, right? Now the B is this direction, K is this direction, so H is positive y direction, this B, K, right? Okay? So H should be positive y. Okay? Now let's look at the solution. Just now we mentioned the frequency, omega is this value, right? Omega is this value. This is given, right? Then f is this frequency, k is from here, k is given, lambda is inflow r is 3, just now we mentioned. The intrinsic impedance, right? This is H field direction, right? E divided by this, okay? This is the phase domain. In case you are asked to write phase domain, this part of domain are instantaneous. Right, correct. Okay, so we have solved the two questions. So, pain wave from getting lossless. So question 3, I will leave to you to solve, okay? Anyway, the solution has been given. Then, one more question, okay? One more. Question 4. For plane wave propagation in lossy mediums, right? Lossy mediums. Okay, this also very important. Okay, very important concept. Magnetic field. Okay, magnetic field. Linear polarized uniform wave propagating in positive y direction. Sea water is a lossy, okay, lossy medium. It's on R mu sigma. Okay, when this sigma is given, is lossy medium. Okay, so magnetic field for this case also we can now. Wave propagate in y direction. Right? Wave propagate in y direction. So here, y equals 0. So in this equation, you cannot see ky, right? You cannot see ky. Actually, in time domain, you should have ky, right? Why you don't have, you cannot see y, ky? Because we assume y is equal to 0. At this location, the magnetic field is equal to this value, right? Okay, now determine the attenuation constant, phase constant, intrinsic impedance, phase velocity, wavelength, skin depth. Okay, as mentioned, okay, this is five star important question. Okay? Then find a location at where at final location amplitude is this value. What are the phasor forms of electric and magnetic? Write expression for latitude and magnetic at this location. Okay? Right? So for this, what you need to do is first you need to determine the ratio. You need to determine this material at this operation frequency is a good conductor or good dielectric material, right? Okay. For this, I would like to see the solution, go through the solution with you together. Okay. So for this case, not quite sure whether you see clearly in the back. At the back, cannot see, right? Too small, right? Okay. Anyway, just now we mentioned all from this here, omega is 10 to 10, right? Okay, 10 to 10 times pi. Right. Okay. Then let me look at this again. Okay, omega is this value, right? Okay. So the criteria is sigma over omega divided by epsilon. Okay. Omega is this value. Now sigma is. Now here, epsilon is epsilon r times epsilon naught. Okay, be careful. Okay. Attention please. Okay, attention please. Some students could make mistake. Okay, to make mistake. Just use epsilon r here. Right? Just use epsilon r. This criteria, okay, should be epsilon r times epsilon naught. Okay? Right? Typical mistake. Typical mistake made by the student. Okay, here is typical mistake made by the student. Okay, some students just use this, some students could just use this. Okay, now turns out this value. So this value, so very typical to say it is a good conductor or a good dielectric material. So then you have to, for this case, the ratio is not small enough. Not small enough. Okay, not small enough. To guarantee the use, the low loss dielectric material. Are dielectric formulas. Therefore, four formulas for alpha, beta, and intrinsic impedance have to be used. So you have to follow those steps. You have to follow these steps. Okay. Then, what is the K? K equal to this, right? Now. Epsilon has real part and the imaginary part, right? Has real part and the imaginary part. Then imaginary, okay? So although you cannot do the square root of a complex number, but you can convert to
explanation for that, right? Then you do the square root or the real part or the imaginary part, not for imaginary, the explanation.
So this could be, you can expect this as, for instance, EJ5, right? Okay, then the square root of this is right. Okay. So you verify
very important. Not just to read. Okay. You need to use your calculator. Okay. To verify. Otherwise, in the quiz or final exam, you cannot arrive at the right answer. Okay. Don't just read. Okay. You need to take out the paper to calculate by yourself, okay?
Then this is beta, this is alpha. This is beta and alpha, okay? Then intrinsic impedance, similarly intrinsic impedance, you can also get by using the same procedure. Turns out you have this value. Then the phase is omega. Now, velocity,
phase velocity is omega over beta, right? The wavelength is 2 pi over beta. Skin depth, right? So up to here, any question? Okay. So it's not difficult, right? Just apply those important concepts, right? Just apply those important concepts.
Then the second question. What is second question? Then find the location. The amplitude, actually compare with the original one, okay, is 1 over 10, right? Okay, here is 0.1, now it's 0.01. So since this is a lossy subject, means at what distance the magnitude is 1 over 10, right? 1 over 10, okay? So then we need to use the attenuation constant. What? Attenuation constant. Now this attenuation constant here. E minus alpha y. Okay. So previously we have already obtained the alpha. Alpha here is attenuation constant. Where is the attenuation constant? Here is, this is a attenuation constant, right? This is beta, then this is alpha, okay? This is alpha, right? Okay, attenuation constant. This, the second question actually quite straightforward, right? Then you can obtain the distance. This distance, right? Not difficult, right? Okay. Then look at the third question. What are the phasor form of electric field and the magnetic field? Phasor form. Okay. Here the tricky point, the tricky is here. Okay. A common mistake is here is a sign. Here is a sign, okay? Typically, the is cosine, right? Is cosine. This 90 degree phase difference will be involved. This is some tricky point, okay? Some tricky point, right? Common mistake. So this here is sine. You need to convert to cosine. Then you will have the right phase. Otherwise, the phase is not correct, right? It's not correct. Okay, this is a tricky problem. Okay, so for this, since the wave propagates in y direction, the HP will take the form. HP typically this cosine omega t minus beta y plus this initial phase. So at this location given by this, so this need to convert to cosine. Convert to cosine, you need to find out this relationship. Okay? This is minus 5/2. So here, this is the tricky point. Okay? Common mistake. Okay? Now, the initial phase will be this value. So the magnitude. Now you have the attenuation, right? This, since it's lossy substrate, this is similar to lossless. So compared with lossless, now we have attenuation constant, initial phase, right? Okay, initial phase. So then electric field. So electric field, now also be careful. Electric field electric field initially in lossless medium, this is the real value. This is the real value. Just previously we mentioned 125 in space, right? Now this is a complex number. Complex number. So previously we have divided. In the first sub-question, right? In the first sub-question, we have divided this. This intrinsic ingredient. Also, as I mentioned many times, to determine the direction, let's do magnetic field, right? Depends on the given condition, okay? So then you should have no difficulty to arrive at this electric field, right? Electric field direction, okay? Electric field direction. Also electric field, now just now find this intrinsic ingredient, okay? So the last one is write the equation for y equal to 0.5, this y equal to 0.5. Just set y equal to 0.5, then attenuation, then this here, right? Okay, this is quite straightforward. Just set the value into this time domain. The time domain expression, okay? Time domain expression. You can get this. You can avoid that means, okay? So, should we go through the. Maybe we quickly go through this one, okay? Question 5. Question 5. A uniform plane wave propagates in seawater. the parameters of seawater, epsilon r, mu r, sigma r, the operation frequency. So also be careful. Okay. Here is megahertz, 10 to x, 10 to 6 is a megahertz, right? Here is 10 to 10 is gigahertz, right? Gigahertz. So now for this low frequency, calculate the attenuation constant, the intrinsic impedance, phase velocity, waves, index, okay? So let's do this one by one. Now for this case, if omega is this value, then based on this criteria, okay, locking in this is 200 greater than 1. So we can assume this is a good conductor at this frequency. So means same material, right? For question 4, is the seawater, right? You cannot assume this as a good conductor or good dielectric material. But however, for this case, we can assume it as a good conductor. For high frequency, this is for low frequency, is a good conductor, right? For this frequency. For previous case, you can assume it is a good dielectric material. Okay, maybe not good. Not quite sure. Right? Not quite sure. Okay? Now, since for this case, then we are very quite simple. So just apply those equations. Right? The attenuation constant, the propagation constant is equal to this equation, right? Equal to this equation. Then just apply the frequency, this mu naught sigma into this equation. You can obtain this, okay? You can obtain this value. Then also for this intrinsic impedance, you can arrive at this. Then you can easily calculate the phase velocity, omega over beta, right? Wavelength 2 pi over beta, 2 over beta. This skin depth is very important, also very important parameter. 1 over alpha. Alpha is attenuation constant, right? Attenuation constant. So then let's look at. So attenuation constant, intrinsic impedance, phase velocity, phase wavelength, skin depth. Okay, right. Then second is let the wave propagate in positive z direction, average power density, and v is equal to this. At z equal to zero, the power is this, power density is this. At find the location. Average power density is 10 to minus 4, right? Means the power will attenuate, right? Will attenuate with the distance, right? Then you need to apply the relationship here is minus 2 R by Z. Why is the power? The electric field will attenuate R by Z. Magnetic field also will attenuate R by Z. So that's why power will attenuate 2 R by Z, right? Okay, now power will attenuate 10 to minus 4 compared with 1. So also this is quite not difficult, okay? So you can obtain the distance, right? 0.5 meters. Okay. Question 6. I will leave question 6, question 7. I will leave to you to solve. Right? So we have completed
tutorial questions for chapter 1 and chapter 2.